or they're full, they haven't forked out the money. So these muddies cost me about $400 per rubber on it. I've got 10 of them. Yes, I have 10 good year anglers. Look, I've only had one blowout, and that was because I had a plug in it, and I didn't realise that the plug was leaking, so I was driving down from up north to Perth, and I didn't click in my mind about the plug, so I forgot I put the plug in it. But I was going to get it sorted when I was in Perth, but the tyre went, so I didn't get around to doing it. But look, it had good mass tread. I was doing 100, 110, 115 on it. It was back right, back left. It went like literally popped. Look, the outside wall disintegrated, basically ripped apart. The inside wall was intact. A lot of the tires and that I actually see, they actually sheared themselves straight off the rim when they blow. I don't know what it is, but it's an interesting one. But look, so one's in my car now, at the front, at the rear. They're the brand new set that I put on last. What are they? They are, I'd say they're about 40, 50,000 Ks. Oh, no, actually less than that. They're probably 30,000, and they've got a shitload of tread. The front is the hard question, because I have so many tyres that I rotate between my car and my trailer. These ones have the most tread, and I'm pretty sure they're only about 60,000 Ks on them. Then you go back to my one in the trailer, so there's a set, which would be about 70,000, and then there's two, which is about 90,000 Ks. They don't wear down at all on the fronts. Like, when you're driving normally, they don't seem to wear as bad as the rear. Look, I'll show you actually how much tread one of my tyres has at the back. It is a 90,000 K tyre. I reckon I could probably get another 20,000 to 30,000 out of it. It's still got probably 5-6 mil tread left. It's not that bad, actually. I'll show you what it is. As you can see here, look at that, that's a good amount of tread, 90,000, but as you can see there, it's starting to crack. So I've basically retired this tyre as a spare. So this is my spare now. Let me see if I can find good crack. It's this one right there, you can see. All over the shop. As you can see, that's good, good size tyre. I like having the good use, but they have none stock. Here's an idea. I've just driven through mud at slow speed, and you can see that's clogged up. But you can't. You can see here on my rear of my car is this. That was from the boot. I booted that. I went a bit faster on that one. But look, I give it a touch, it all flicks out. So this is what. So that's about my 70,000 K one. Same as the spare. That wheel and that wheel is about 70,000. I have one more wheel up north at the moment. I've got to go retrieve it at some point. But yeah, it's not that bad. You can see, kevlar, they're good strong tyres. Never puncture this tight pattern here for grip, and this bit here for a bit larger bit for the flick mud out as well. I've tried spinning these tyres in the wet, cannot do it. They just instantly grab as soon as they, like you might get two, three rotations out of it.